He's one of the key figures in the battle over reopening businesses. We speak to Democratic State Representative Kevin Boyle coming up next. Plus, it's a push to help essential workers at the federal level. I speak with the PA congressman trying to make a tax-free holiday for grocery and convenience store workers. Back in a moment. And welcome back. One of the committees that's been at the heart of the push to reopen parts of the state is the House State Government Committee. And this morning I'm joined by Democratic Chair of the committee, Representative Kevin Boyle. Representative Boyle, how are you doing? How is your family doing throughout this?
We're doing pretty well. Thank you for asking, Rob. And happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there.
Yeah, we have to wish all the moms out there a happy Mother's Day. Representative, let's start with, I don't know if you could hear my conversation with Representative Ryan. He's also on the same committee as you, the government committee. You do want to get things moving again. However, you just recently sat on the House floor, and a lot of people agree with you, but the worst thing to do is to end the shutdown too fast. How do you feel about other counties who are jumping in on this red to yellow move, even though they're not part of what the governor wants?
I just think they're being too hasty. So far, we have been successful in Pennsylvania in limiting the spread just really to the eastern part of the state. We've been able to stifle its spread for the most part from going into central Pennsylvania and western Pennsylvania. The shutdown has been working. By these counties in the Harrisburg metropolitan area prematurely reopening, they're exposing their citizens to an outbreak.
Here's just one out of the blue. Why was closing down so much easier?
Well, it was, I think we saw what was happening in New York, and I think there was a political consensus that we didn't want to replicate what was going on in New York City or Italy, for that matter. And now we've actually been successful, at least here in Pennsylvania, in stifling this spread. And obviously people are getting impatient, and I understand that. And we all want to reopen, though.
Don't you think it would have been smart, though, to wait 14 days from when some of the other states of our country opened up just to see how they do?
Well, I think the right approach is the approach that the Wolf administration has been following, which has been data and science led. And I believe individual counties really should take their lead from the Wolf administration.
So how do you feel about opening up, putting out waivers there to open up things like barbershops and hair salons to reopen during the pandemic?
Well, I think that, well, we've had legislation like that in the House State Government Committee, of which I am the Democratic chair. Representative Ryan is a Republican member. I have opposed the immediate reopening of barbershops and some other service sector economic parts of the economy. I think that we need to make sure that the spread is limited before we begin to reopen this economy.
You know, one thing, I was doing a political program every week like this for years now, was that there was no politicization of the coronavirus or the pandemic in the beginning. That certainly has changed. And in fact, he got into sort of a dust up with a rep from Jefferson County, who I won't mention, but I've heard this from other politicians also, feel that the governor's administration is the same as the Nazi party, far right from the socialist playbook. The rhetoric is getting more harsh.
It's true, and that's really regrettable, that sort of terminology by the representative from Jefferson County. Not only is it inflammatory, particularly to the Jewish community, we saw 6 million people of the Jewish faith die in the Holocaust due to the actions of the Nazi regime, but on substance, nothing could be further from the truth. What the Wolf administration has been doing in relation to the shutdown has been about preventing the loss of human life.
Do you feel that the administration could have been more transparent? Last week I had Senator Mike Regan, a Republican, on, and he and some other lawmakers subpoenaed the governor for information about shutdowns and how long they're going to last and things like that. The governor defied that subpoena, claiming executive privilege. But so my question would be, they're even trying to take this to court, essentially.
Well, I know that the Wolf administration did release data on Friday afternoon. And they've also indicated to us in the legislature, not only am I the Democratic chair of the state government committee, I'm also a member of the House Government Oversight Committee, they have indicated to us on that committee that they will participate in the review of the waiver process. So I look forward to working with the Wolf administration and my Republican colleagues on investigating what went right in terms of the waiver process, but also what went wrong.
It would be hard to come up with a program, I would think, like that, that quickly, that would be what you would call perfect. But as we move into this next phase, you can see more of the Commonwealth deciding to open up possibly faster before the governor's orders. Do you think education is the key? Because, you know, businesses can open, but if people feel that their lives could be in danger or they're not safe, they're just not going to go.
That's absolutely true. And that is the experience that we're seeing in Georgia. And I would counsel some of those county commissioners in Dauphin County and Lebanon County to look at what's happened in Georgia and even look at what's happening in northwestern Pennsylvania. Businesses are not seeing the customers that they saw before the shutdown began because the confidence just isn't there. The only way to have a strong economy is to get this pandemic under control. And that's what really the approach of the Wolf administration has been. And we, the Democrats on the House State Government Committee, have been allies in that approach.
Representative Kevin Boyle, my guest this morning on Face of the State Live. Thanks for joining us. Again, have a great Sunday and stay healthy. Stay safe.
Thank you, Rob.